Hey, Kevin Lawrence here. Special video edition of our newsletter today for a very important day. It's September 10th and it's Suicide Awareness Day. Yes, I know it sounds really heavy, but I want to share with you some insights because right now there's a lot of mental strain that people are having, a lot of extra stress in the world. Welcome to 2020. But I want to share a couple slides from my keynote. I've been doing my keynote a lot these days from Your Oxygen Mask First. I want to show you a few principles about the chapter that relate to mental health and might help you if you're mentally being a little cooked, as many of us have been, and also some ideas that would help those that might be in a little more need or a little more strain these days. So, 1 second here, I get to the right slide. Sorry, I'm just doing this real kind of last minute because I was just thinking it'd be a great thing to share today. So my keynote, The Gravity of Stress, ensuring you and your team stay resilient. And a key quote from my book, there's no in-between with leadership. Either it slowly destroys your life or it forces you to get stronger. I prefer the get stronger part, and that's what I'm about as a coach and helping people to do, obviously. We've seen this all around the world, and kind of the two books I've already done a lot of work around. That's the new one coming. The point of this thing is about stress. Stress can be your friend, but then stress can try to kill you if it's too much. Our best performance happens up in that sweet spot, that little purple box up there. But as the stress pushes more and more and more as we go over to the right, we get burnout, meltdown. And then after that, people have some serious mental health issues and red lights. And you know, many CEOs, execs, and leaders that we're talking to these days, more than you would think, are actually down in that flashing red light. I've got 5 that I'm touching base with on a weekly basis. Just, hey, how you doing? Are you getting the help you need? Can I support you in any way? And for me, it's, you know, making sure they get to the psychologist or counselor they need to help them unpack some of the garbage that's built up in their head with these crazy situations. And I'm not judging the garbage. It's just, it's a lot of stuff builds up and a lot of pressure, and they got to find a way to bring the pressure, bring the stress back, and kind of recover from that. And the thing is for you to think about is, where are you and your team on this curve? Because if you get pushed over to the right, it really hurts. And we layer in here this thing called the mental health continuum. The mental health associations around the world use this simple, beautiful model where your mindset goes from green, yellow, orange to red. And after red, you know, it's that's where things like suicide come up in people's mind, and they start having these crazy thoughts because they think they're down in that horrible place and they're not going to be able to get back up. Simple for us to say when we're not in that place. The key is that all of us are 1 or 2 life events away from being in that red zone. And I know for myself, I got really cooked this year through COVID. So much I was doing to try and support my family and work with my clients and just the stress of the situation. It was actually probably the hardest I've worked in probably at least 15 years since I started going to the Middle East. Point of this is that life gets a shot on us, hits us the wrong way, and we get hurt. So we've got a tool that we have if you want a copy to share with your teams. Happy to share it with you. Just email Janice at my office or email the office, where it has some of these tools to share. But the thing is, this continuum, it breaks down, and I've labeled these different kind of paths that there are and how things like your mood or your anxiety or your ability to work or think or sleep or your energy or your health or your coping mechanisms / addictions change as you get stressed. And the thing is, this happens to everyone. It is part of the journey, but there's such a stigma around it. And what I want you to get today is, we don't want there to be such a stigma, and we want the people to get the help that they need so that they don't suffer in that red zone when they don't need to because they're embarrassed or ashamed. Yet it's normal. It's normal to get to red. I got to red in, I know I was there probably in June. A few funny stories I could tell you, but I won't. But just where my aggressiveness would get over the top. And like many people, I was drinking more than I normally did, a whole bunch of things. So I just check mark some things that I know I experienced. So the thing for you to think about with the people around you is, if you're noticing any of these behaviors, just search up mental health continuum, or obviously look at the slide here. But the final thing I want, and this is relates to suicide prevention, is this thing called ALGI. You know, we know what to do if people have a medical first aid, physical. You know, we know call 911. Many people would know CPR or things like this. Well, this is what you do if someone's having a mental meltdown. You know, their brain stops functioning. You know, addictions get out of control. They're freaking out. They're thinking of hurting themselves. It's ALGEE. Again, look it up. The root of it is to assess for risk of suicide or harm. So, you know, I regularly ask, have you been having some crazy thoughts and thought about suicide? I ask this blatantly in private. And if they are, we need to get them to the professional help like right away, which would be right away to psychologist, counselor, doctor. If it's really, really in grave danger, right to emergency, like we would if it was a compound fracture of their leg. Listen non-judgmentally, hear them out. Give reassurance and information. don't tell them about starving kids in Africa and how they should be grateful. That doesn't help. Making them feel guilty for feeling bad is not the strategy, although we have good intentions sometimes. But just let them know, hey, there's this thing called the mental health continuum. You should look at it. You know, even when you're red and you think you can't get back, you can always get healthy. Get the right professional help. That's it. Doctor will help them get to a counselor or psychologist. Counselor, psychologist. Get to a professional. We are not equipped to handle medical emergencies and brain surgery. We are not equipped to handle this ourselves either. And then encourage self-help and other strategies. That's another chapter in my book about resilience rituals. Generally, people need to get back to exercise, socializing, quality time with their family, proper sleep, you know, the basics, and those resilience rituals are usually what people need. So in the book, you can self-assess. I'm talking here about chapter 6, deal with your emotional junk under clarity, and under energy, chapter 3, which is about your resilience. And chapter 11, quadruple your IQ, which is having expert psychologist counts or whatever it is on your team. So the root of it is resilience and taking care of yourself and getting the help that you need when it gets crazy. So my request of you is, if you are in that red zone or orange zone and thinking help, get help. If you're not sure what to do, ask me. I will help you find the help that you need. We deal with it all the time. I am not a psychologist, but I've become an expert in helping people through mental health issues because I work with really driven people that get into this. And our hope is that we don't lose any more good people around us because the stress gets to them and then they make a snap judgment in a time of massive pain. So help those around you. Sit and have a chat with someone that you think might be stressed and see how they're doing. And at the end of the day, you know, life is grand. But when we're not in the right mindset, we miss that and we might need a bit of help getting back. All right. Have an awesome day. All the best.